What's up, guys? Today we're going to be talking about what financial literacy means at a young age. My name is Kevin Murray, and this channel is all about personal finance tips and long-term investing. Ask yourself this question: what does financial literacy mean to you? Is it about being rich? Is it about not working? Is it about starting your own business or working for 40 or 50 years on a company and climbing the ladder, becoming a CEO of a Fortune 500 company? Each person is different. Everyone has different motives and goals in life and what they want to do in this lifetime. Everyone's on their own journey. Everyone has different lessons they want to learn. And as a person, you have to keep learning, being present in the moment. What does financial literacy mean to me at a young age, someone that's in college? To me, it's just having that awareness that money could work for you in your life. Most people aren't aware that financial literacy or money in general could work for you in life, which is called passive income. The idea that money could work for you in your sleep. You don't have to do anything. It just works for you, essentially. Like, everyone has one source of income from their part-time job or their 9-to-5 job. They're either having a salary or an hourly wage. And you can't just be reliant on just one source of income in life. The first thing that comes to mind for me is investing. What are the things you could do to start making passive income with investing? You could be a long-term investor in the stock market, or two, investing in real estate. Let's focus on stock market investing in this video, because I'm someone that's very knowledgeable and very passionate about personal finance and investing in general, because stock market can make you a lot of money, millions, the next 10 and 20 years. But it takes a lot of patience and discipline to be like that. Like, the great Warren Buffett didn't create his wealth over time. It took him decades to create billions of dollars in his portfolio or in his net worth. He doesn't care about the day-to-day fluctuations of that stock price. He invests in well-run, fundamentally good companies that he understands on a high level, have revenues that are growing year over year, have a good executive management team that knows what they're doing, have experience in the market. It's knowing the concept of compounding. The more you have it, the more it's going to grow. The effects of compounding might not take effect at a young age, but over time, you're going to see it when you're a young adult or in your 40s or 50s, and even your 60s and 70s, you're going to see it grows like an exponential curve or an S curve. And like with being a long-term investor, it's about being patient, disciplined, and being unemotional. It saves you as a person later in life. And it's all about like your belief systems. If you could do it, you could do it. If you can't, you can't. You're just going to attract whatever you're thinking about. Energy attracts energy. Like attracts like. Anyone could start investing. You don't need a financial advisor to tell you what to do, how to start saving, how to invest in the stock market. It just takes the right systems and knowledge. If you want to start investing in the stock market, but you don't want to do the work of investing like Warren Buffett does, reading hundreds of financial statements, get a return of 20% and 30%. It takes a lot of work and discipline, but you can make a lot of money with this time and energy. You could go that route, but a more common route, like most financial advisors tell you to do, is to invest in an index fund. Invest in VOO, VU, or VTI. And these funds track the market like the S&P 500, and they give you a return of between 6 and 8% each and every single year compounded. You beat inflation, and it doesn't take any skills to invest in these funds. You get conservative returns and you have money invested for you passively. And throughout history, if you could track, stock market has always been going up from economic booms, innovation, disruption, people spending more, GDP increasing. There's many economic things you could talk about, but stock market has been historically always been going up throughout history. And if you start investing right now in high school or in college and just let that compounding work for you, type in a compounding calculator on Google and type in 6-8% return 30 years and put the amount of money you want to invest each and every single month. You could play around with the numbers. You might do the work and get double or triple or quadruple what the market brings each and every single month. You could do it if you surround yourself with the right people. For me, I'm surrounding myself with 6- and 7-figure investors in the stock market. They know what they're doing. Kind of, I'm getting their knowledge and wisdom at a young age. And another thing, what makes you like financial literate, besides having asset producing incomes, having more streams of passive income than your 9-to-5 or part-time job, is to define like what your rich life is. A book I'm reading right now is called I Will Teach You to Be Rich by Ramit Sethi. I hope I'm pronouncing that right, but I think I am. And he asked this question like at the beginning of the book. What is your specific rich life? Like, everyone says, I want to be a millionaire. I want to be a billionaire. But if you define to be specific what you want out of your rich quote unquote life, what is it? Do you want to travel the United States with an RV and make $30,000 a year? You don't want to have to worry about money when you're on vacations. You want to stay at the nicest hotels, 5 stars, go out to fancy restaurants and go to the clubs and get bottles. Do you want to take your friends and family with you on your vacation and you spend it on them for experiences? Just sit down and journal and see what comes up. When I read that, like, whoa, it makes like really like a lot of sense. We don't define and be specific a lot in our life. I want my rich life to be blank and blank. I want my specific job to be this and be making this amount of money each and every single month. I want my fitness goal to have this blank body because of why. And ask yourself why. That's the most important thing. You don't want to have a goal and just keep thinking about it. Ask yourself, why do you want it? And is this for yourself or for other people? And the next thing is, or number three, is to have being a more high value person. If you want to expand your income, you got to have value as a person. What are kind of like unique skills you have or are passionate about that not a lot of people are? What are things that you love to talk about, passionate about, and you know a lot about? For me, I know a lot about personal finance and investing. I could talk about this stuff for hours. It makes me money. It makes people, other people money. Like knowing this like simple concepts of it. You don't have to be a genius to do it. Or if you're an artist or you like making crafts or you just have a lot of knowledge about a specific thing in fitness, that gives you value and people will pay for your value for exchange of money. Starting your own business from your passion, you can make money off it, but it just takes the right infrastructure. Like I said, like reading or taking the time to just invest into yourself, or it's going to compound over time. It's going to be a high value person in society and to your friends, which leads to increased income. Finalizing this video, just wrapping up everything, like everything in life is a process. You're not going to be rich overnight. You're not going to be making hundreds of thousands of dollars from your business or from your job overnight. It's a process, a journey. Keep on with it, be consistent with it, and just improve each and every single day. Just compound yourself each and every single day. If it's a small one, everything adds up. And over time, you see this gigantic goal getting manifested into your life and see your growth over time as a person. And like the saying, the rich get richer, because why? They know what financial literacy is. What does financial literacy mean to you? What is financial literacy mean to me? Having asset producing incomes and not relying on one source of income in your life. Investing to yourself and investing to the stock market as a long-term investor. Buy and hold. That's it. That's the most winning strategy in the market. There's no, okay, this is how you make 25K in one day. There's no such thing as that. How to get rich quick schemes. It's not sustainable in the long term. And if there was, a lot of people, including me, would be millionaires with the amount of time I spent with researching stocks and keeping up with my personal finance skills. Having more value as a person, increasing your skills of what you love and just monetizing that skill, freelancing or starting your own online business that revolves around your passion, defining what your rich life is, picture it, and then you can manifest it. Focus on that and be specific down to the detail. You don't have to be frugal. Spend money on the things you love. If it's food, clothing, shoes, no one's stopping you. Thank you for watching and peace out.